Today I'm painting a rooftop scene from Tuscany, Italy. I will explain how I paint from light to dark and from big shapes to small shapes. Here's the source photo, which I'm going to crop down to just the rooftops and the tower. I'm using a 2B mechanical pencil and a quarter sheet of Arches cold press watercolor paper. I use different brands of paper and they are all very good. And I do recommend using a top quality paper, even for beginners who want to work wet on wet. You can only do so with artist quality paper. Cheaper paper will only prove futile. I'm going to start with a light wash to define the sky and also to cover most of the paper. I'm leaving a few spots of white paper just to break up the large shapes. The next layer of paint will consist of darker values, but still not the darkest values. I'm going to paint the large shapes of the rooftops and the building facades and leave out any major detail. Just as before with the initial wash, I'm leaving a few holes to act as highlights. I'm also varying the color, keeping those large areas interesting. Although I'm working wet on dry initially, I'm dropping in different hues and making some connections between the large shapes to allow the colors to bleed into one another. I'm careful to keep in mind the direction of light so that I apply the correct values to the correct areas of the buildings. Now that I've better defined the buildings, I'm going to work on the background of the mountains and valley. I'm still working with big shapes, although I'm using a combination of some wet on dry and wet on wet strokes to add interest. I continue the work on the background mountains and valleys with darker values and more detail, but I'm only making suggestions of fields and trees. I will save more detailed paint strokes for the mid and foreground. I'm adding some trees and bushes amongst the buildings, even though they are not in the source photo. I want to add some natural elements to the midground and foreground, and I want to break up the group of buildings. Thank you. Now I'm starting with some of the detail in Darkest Darks. It's going to look a little cartoon-like at first, and I even soften some of those lines eventually. But as I add more detail of the tile roofs and the shadows of the eaves, those lines will not stand out quite as much. I work on creating the shadows under the overhangs of the roof of the buildings. This may take a couple of layers to get the value that I'm looking for. Now I'm adding the windows and doors to better define the buildings. Last, I will add cast shadows from the tower and some of the chimneys on the rooftops. This will help give the illusion of sunlight. And here is the final painting. As always, if you have any comments or questions, please add them below. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.